Happy morning, friends. So, as per plan, we are starting this program about Zoom advanced option and about security in Zoom. In this application, actually, you can switch off your chat and listen to the session during the program, or at the end of the program, I'll be giving you time to ask questions or have for discussion. At that time, we'll discuss in detail. So the purpose of this program is recently we got lot of information about these kind of webinar applications, whether is it security or not. So for this question, just I want to tell you one thing. It is just my opinion. It is not a survey or it is not anything. It is my opinion. As we are in digital world, most of our information are not that much secured. We need to accept that anyhow. But these application, what government are trying to say is we need to reduce using it, or we need to go for some options to make a security. So namakku namale security paathukiradhukku nama enna pananum enna pannikalam abingira steps pannikonga abingiradha information dhaan kuduthirukanga. They are not saying that you don't use with some security precaution. That is the input we are getting from the government. So what we are going to see is today, before getting to the session, I just want to introduce about myself, because many people, I got lot of appreciation in the application. So in this, when I was coming through those application, many people are new to me. And the first thing which I was happy today is, most of the decision which I got, 80% it is new people, and some people are watching on live also, so you can post your comment. So I'm Tamila Karthik. Being a placement coach, I have trained more than 1.8 lakh students on interview skills. I have somewhat around 9+ years experience in my training career, and being an activity based coaching facilitator, we have organized 5+ train the trainer event in different cities and much more training to corporates. So activity based coaching, ABC is my core training concept, where we are focusing only on activity. And we have conducted more than 1,000+ webinars on online CRM, customer relationship management, and digital management and marketing and power your presentation. And of course, we started training on how to conduct webinars also. And I'm proud to say I'm the member of Negli Foundation, also the member of Panch Curriculum, and I'm the past president of JCI Tirthangal and Zone Trainer of JCI India. And I'm also the member of EC, member of Computer Dealer Association. So now, why this program today? The purpose of today's program is to know what are all the settings and security options which we need to do in this Zoom application. In between, if you have any queries, you can post questions in the chat box. I'm ready to respond to those answers also. Once this lockdown period started, what I was doing is, like, always as a business person, I used to say, others' problem is your own project. If you think like this, definitely all your project will get succeed. So even though we were doing a lot of webinars, I started training the people on how to conduct webinars, and we got 70 paid registration. That was really, I was so happy, because 70+ paid registration we got for how to conduct webinar in my first webinar itself in this lockdown period. So after this, particularly to those audience, I just want to share this, dedicate this video, as you need to learn some more advanced concepts also. That is a first point which I want to convey in this program. And next one, there are a lot of options which we are not using in this Zoom application, that we need to be very clear. So there are many options are there in the applications. Are we using those applications? We need to think those things. First one, most of us are hosting the program only in mobile. If you want to host a program, if you want to conduct a training program or online meeting, just go for browser. In browser, do your login, get your ID, and here you just schedule the meeting so that you can get all the options of scheduling a meeting or a webinar. So this is the first reason. The reason I want to say this is, in mobile, it is the purpose for client usage, not for the like server or like host. So prefer this zoom.us browser. And I just want to clear, some of my friends have told me, are you the promoter of Zoom? Why are you training people on Zoom like that? People were asking me. It was just like, I just want to answer those questions. I'm not a marketing executive for Zoom applications. I just want to share my learning part. So even in the Zoom application in our laptop, we will be having this kind of screen. Here in this option, you'll be having profile. I'm getting some chat. Yeah, Ramya ma'am, I'm going to share about the privacy in my upcoming slides. So in the Zoom application settings, by clicking your profile name, if you are having my profile, directly you will be pop up to the browser page. During the program, you can see the participants list. The first security measurement which you need to do is, by clicking this more option, you'll be having some method. Before that, whenever you are hosting a program, most of the people who are hosting the training on Zoom application, they are forget to mute the participant. Even though if you have muted the participants during the program, they need to disable this, uncheck this option of allow participant to unmute themselves. If this option is enabled, definitely people can unmute themselves and they can talk at any time. So uncheck this option and save this. This is the first security which I want to tell, because this is the problem we are occurring during the program. And this next one is chat box. In chat box, in this three dot, you'll be having a more option. In the more option, you'll be having these kind of options. You just need to select either no one or host only, so that either host only can send the message, others can just receive the message. If you select everyone publicly, anyone can send the message. If you select everyone publicly and privately, even one participant can interact with another participants also. So this is the second point which I want to give you about the security between one participant to another participant. The main thing, let me go somewhat fast. As you are a Zoom user, definitely you will be knowing all these options. So I'm going somewhat fast. If you still don't understand, just ping me in my chat box or in Facebook live window. Both I'm watching, I can give you input. Like whenever you are starting a program, the first security precaution what government is saying is, don't use your personal ID. This is your personal meeting ID. This, you don't use that particular personal meeting ID for any of your programs. So whenever you are using your personal meeting ID, that ID will be conveyed for all your programs. So when you are scheduling a program, don't select that particular personal ID, go for generate automatically. And also go with the option called password. So the meeting ID will be also generate automatically, and password also will generate. Either password also, you can type your own password in even in basic version or paid version like us. So this is the main thing what government want to say to the citizens. And the second thing, today for this webinar, this much people are attending in this Zoom application, and people are watching on my Facebook page also. And what happened today, when you are coming to this program, you don't get the meeting ID directly. I have given you the meeting link. From the meeting link, once you have filled your own personal data, your information, the meeting ID will be displayed to you. And also it will be mailed to your personal window. So this is a main security precaution which you need to do. Because if you are sharing your meeting ID and password, anyone can join at any time. So you need to be, could I record this? Yes, ma'am, I can allow you to record. You can record this. Or you can watch in my Facebook Live, which I am sharing you the live link in the chat box. Yes, okay. I'll be going somewhat little slower as Ramya ma'am is expecting. Okay, no problem. So what I was saying is, whenever you are hosting a program, don't use your personal meeting ID. Go for generate automatically and also have password for your Zoom applications, for your meetings. And even though I'm not suggesting you to use those options if it is not a closed program, what you can do is you can simply use this registration option. I'll show you how to use those registration option. Come to my browser. Here we'll be having I'll be showing you how to schedule a meeting with some registration. Give me a minute, it is loading. Yeah, so in the browser, whenever you are hosting a program, you need to select this, you need to type your own topic and type the description and type the time when you want to host the program and select this option. You need to select registration required. Just select that option and you'll be having registration required. If you select that option called registration required, without registration, people will not be joining the program. So you will be getting all the record of actually some people are asking how to record your speech. Actually, this program, I have disabled the recording option to the participants to record because I just want to have live in my page. If you want the recording video, I can send you later. Even I can share you in my email ID. As of now, here you will not be able to record. Or you can find me on Facebook page or in my YouTube page. Both you can get it. Hope I'm clear to Prabhu sir and Ramya ma'am. Sorry, RR ma'am. So kindly understand, I have disabled the option for recording, allow participant to record. I'll show you what is the purpose of those. So whenever you're hosting a program, you should enable this one. Enable waiting room, you should enable. The purpose of enable waiting room is, well, if you enable this waiting room, whenever participants are getting into your program, once you click on admit, only participants will be able to join your meeting, or else participant will not be able to join. That is the purpose of enable waiting room. And this option, enable join before the host, this option you should disable, you should uncheck it, because what will happen is, if you are hosting the program, if you are scheduled the program by 11 o'clock, but you are late by 5 minutes, means in this 5 minutes, any other participants who are registered or who are having your user ID and who are having your meeting ID and password will be able to join before the host get in. So this option should be disabled, as we don't want to people get interacted before our session start. So that's why always you should disable this option if you are going for open meeting. If you are going for closed meeting with your colleagues, with your friends, with your family, you can enable this meeting. Even if you are not available, you can simply, you don't need to even start the meeting. The meeting will be started automatically by 11 a.m. or whatever the time you have scheduled, the program will be started. But there will not be any host. That is the only option you will not be getting. I'm getting some chat box. Let me check. They are saying thank you, welcome. So the next one is, when you are having this option, only authenticate user can join, sign into Zoom. This option will be having a high secured one, because some anonymous users, so who don't register for your program or who don't even have mail ID, will not be able to join. So they need to create a Zoom application, login first. After that only they can able to join your meeting. That is the purpose of this. Only authenticated user can join. So you should enable this option if you want to have high security in this Zoom application. So our government are not saying not to use the program application. We need to like enable these kind of all these kind of options. This is the main thing. So for example, if you have any, if you have done all this enabling check and you have sent a registration link for a program, how can you monitor who have registered for the program? That you need to be very sure, because for as I told you earlier, if I am conducting some paid program, like if I am conducting some paid program, I just want to allow only the participants who have paid for my program. How can I monitor? This is the question which I got in my TNA. Some people have asked me. So for that, what we can do is, here you can see the option called upcoming meetings. So in this upcoming meetings, you are having, hope it is visible. If this upcoming meeting page is not visible, kindly post in chat. So in this, I'm having today with this meeting Zoom security. So I'm clicking on this meeting day title. I'm getting the detail of my today meeting. So here under this, you'll be having the extra option called registration. So how many registration I got today, which will be monitored here. And by clicking this view option, we can see all those datas. And here I have automatically approved option. What you can do is, if it is a paid program, you should not have the option called automatically record. You need to go for manually approved. So the power of this manually approved option is, what it will be doing is, only if you are manually approving that particular user or that particular mail ID, they'll be able to join and they'll be even getting the meeting ID and password in their mail. So the mail will be automatically sent to the registered participant of your program. So this manual approval will not be useful for these kind of complement programs. So these kind of complement free programs, you can go for automatically approve, or if you want to go for paid program, go for manual approval, so that it will be easy for you to maintain who are attending your programs. So this option, in this other option, we have close registration after event date. If you enable this, for example, today is our event, 23rd of April. If you enable this program, people will not be allowed to register on 23rd, this day. So social share buttons on registration page, this will allow your participants to share your registration link with their Facebook page or Google page or Twitter or all other social media page. All the options will be available over there. And in these questions, you can monitor what are the, so today in this program, I have asked their last name and just phone number. Even the phone number, I don't want to compel them to give their phone number. So I have not enabled this record option. So if I enable this record option, without typing your phone number, you will not be able to register for the event. But I just disable this, so you'll be able to register even without giving your phone number data. So in these custom questions, what you can do is, you can create your own customer questions. For example, you want to get some TNA, training need analysis, from your participants. You can type your own questions and just select save all. So you'll be able to, your questions will be visible to the participants by only typing the questions. Their name will be displayed in this registration page, and you can either approve or reject those participants. So this email settings, you can just configure your own mail ID. It is your own account mail ID, where this is my Karthik Alay Sindhian, my personal mail ID. So from this mail ID, it will be sending a automatic message to all your participants, those who have registered. So confirmation email to registrants sent upon registration. So if this enable, I can even edit this option. So whenever about your program, you can type here, thanks for registering for this title. Automatically the title of the program will be coming. So you can type your own customization message, either your phone number or contact details or about the program or objective about the program. You can, all those details you can type over here. After typing these programs, you can just save this, and this template mail will be directly automatically mailed to all the customers. And one more advantage is, if you are a business person, if you are a branding, if you want your brand to promote with all the people, just select upload your banner about that current today program. You can, if you upload this one, when you are getting your registration, when people are clicking your registration link, they can able to see the banner, and you can even upload your logo part. So if this logo part is uploaded, your company logo will be displayed. So you can even create poll during the program, or you can put even live streaming in Facebook, workplace, YouTube, all those custom, your even your own live page. These are all the options which you need to enable in the security options. Like I was saying that don't use your personal meeting ID, use generate automatically. This is the first method. And second method, what you can go for registration. Only the registered participant will be able to join. So let us go on to the next model of what we want to learn today. So this one, host key. This is a wonderful security option which Zoom application is having. I don't find these kind of options in some other webinar applications. So what is the purpose of this host key is, for example, you are hosting a program and by mistake you have made someone else as host and you have left the meeting. So what happened? You are the host, you are organizing a program, by mistake you have made a participant as a host and you are left to the program. What you can do, you can log in from any other mail ID and there will be option called claim host. In the claim host, if you are typing this host key, you will be become the host again. So this is a wonderful option. For example, what is the difference in basic option and paid option is, in basic option, they'll be having a one host key, which you can't edit. Whereas in my paid option of application, you will be able to even edit your host key. That is the option which we are having. And this is a page which we are having in our mobile application. Even, sir, I'm hosting the program only in mobile. Teach me the inputs. Teach me security option, you may ask. So for those people, you can just open your Zoom application. It will be looking like this. Just to click on settings. In the settings, you will be having, even while you are scheduling the meeting itself, you will be having some options called enable waiting room, which I told you already, you should enable the waiting room if you want to see your participant who are coming, and once you accept only, they can able to join. So if you are going for open meeting, don't enable this option. Allow join before host. As I told you already, this option should be disabled because once host start the meeting only, people will be able to join. And participant video on, and these are all the basic options which you can, if you want to know how to schedule a meeting, how to join a meeting, all the very basic stuffs, you can search in my YouTube page, Tamila Karthik. You can find about Zoom basics. And this lock share, in mobile itself, we have an option called lock share, which means only host will be able to share any like PPT or image or video, all those things. Participant will be just able to see the meeting. They'll not be able to share anything. So for that, you need to enable this option. And lock meeting, this is another security option which we need to learn is, for example, you are having a closed meeting of your friend with your friend circle or with your family, of you are planning for 15 participants. All the 15 participants have already into the program. You can just click on this option to just lock the meeting. So it is like closing your room. Other participants will not be able to join it again, even though they're having ID and password. Meeting ID and password, if they have also, they'll not be able to join if this option is enabled. And all others are basic only. You don't need to know much. And I just want to go for another information. If you have any other, some very important information, I just want to go. Give me a minute. So in your browser, just click on settings and you'll be promoted a page like this. I'm sharing my screen. Hope it is visible. So this option I have already told, join before the host, it should be disabled. And this option, use personal meeting ID when scheduling a meeting, this should be disabled. So as I told you, you should not use your personal meeting ID, and this option should be enabled. Only authenticated user can join the meeting. So people need to register in Zoom application so that they can join any meeting. These three options is enough in this page. And next we have record a password when scheduling a new meeting. If you are enabling this, it will be asking for the password what to set. So you can set the password what you can go with your client. Even for instant meeting, do you want a password? For this, this is the option. You can use this. Very important one is mute participant upon entry. So if this option is enabled only, even so now we have some huge audience. If some extra audience are coming, and if only if this option is enabled, they'll be able to mute. They'll be able to. They'll not be able to talk, or else they'll be disturbing the session. So that you need to think about muting this particular option. And upcoming meeting reminder, if you enable this, the reminder will be coming to your mail and your desktop pop-up. You can get reminder about your upcoming meeting schedules also. And chat, you can enable this if you want to interact with all the participants, or you can disable this. If this option is enabled, one participant will be able to chat with another participants. So if you don't want to, just disable this. Auto saving chat should be disable if this is it should be enabled if this is enabled. When you close your meeting, the total meeting chat box will be saved in your local computer, so it will be definitely useful for you. Play sound when participant join or leave. So this sound will be coming to us when participant join or leave our meeting, so we will be get to know. This file transfer option will be disabled if you don't want to transfer files. If you want to transfer file to your clients, you can enable the file transfer option. So who can share? As I told you already, please keep host only, because most of the time we don't allow participants to share anything. So we'll be making the participants to not to show, we'll be sharing. So for this, you can enable host only. So what you can do when you are going for annotation, if this annotation program should be enabled, because only if you it should be disabled. Only if you disable, only participant will not be able to draw something in your own screen. Or else, if this option is enabled, anyone can able to write on your own screen. It will be totally irritation to all the participants. So this annotation option you should disable. And this is the next option which you want to learn today. So whenever you are handling these kind of the basic settings, all your applications are, this application, Zoom applications are totally secured. You don't need to worry about that. But still, some people may ask some questions like, sir, they are saying that people are hearing or like observing what we are talking in the Zoom application. You can think from your end, for what purpose we are using this application. Most of us are using learning part. Even though in this lockdown period, our learning part may be reduced, but our learning part are increasing. So even if some people are watching our program or recording our program and learning, means why we need to worry. Just take it as easy. And second one is the basic problem what government wanted us to convey is, if we are using for a huge purpose like defense system, they need to worry about. So as we are using for learning part, why do not need to worry about that, whether they are recording our options or not. So this is the first option I need to say. And second one about our personal data. So when for this program, you have given me your mail ID and phone number. That too, I'm enabling as option. So if you don't want to give, you just don't need to, you can skip it. Even if you are giving your dummy mail ID, you'll be allowed to attend the session. Got my point? So these kind of personal data, not only in Zoom application, in any digital platform, you can take any digital platform, it is stored in their own server. So like our mobile number, mail ID, our address, all those things. So you can think about that. It is just a Today, now I'm going to make a polling. So just I want to answer from you people. So in your screen, you'll be having your questions. You can just click on your answers. Do you have experience in hosting a Zoom meeting or a webinar? Yeah, I got the answer. Yes. Do you want to know alternative to Zoom? Zoom application illama na vera or pudhu application neraya therinjikon nenikiren appdin irukravanga you can host. Or do you want online event anchor OMC? You know about what is MC, who are doing anchor? If you want to go for online event anchor, means for example, if you may host some program, for hosting the program, you may be the trainer and just you want to make people interactive, so you can call us for event anchoring. So I'll be showing the result here. So hope you that the results are like giving to you. So this poll option is again available in paid version where you can utilize to interact with your own participants. And next information which I want to share to today participant is tomorrow we have a program on alternative to Zoom. So we are sir, whatever options, whatever reasons you are saying, I'm not comfortable, I'm not satisfied, I just want to I'm having afraid of using this application, just you don't use. Tomorrow we'll meet on how to use some other Zoom webinar application which is same like Zoom, and I can probably say it is also a Indian company, so which we are going to learn tomorrow. This is a registration link. This is a time tomorrow morning by same time, 11 to 11:30, we are going to meet. So even in our yes, Master of Ceremony is nothing but I'll show those event also. This is a program which I'm having a collaboration with Chennai Event MCs. The founder of SNC is Mr. Tamilarasan and Ms. Nandini. So both of them are doing a great job. Along with them, we are having doing online event anchoring. If you are having a training program or office meeting or online classes or club meeting, anything, you can call us for recruiting. So we'll be doing all kind of hosting work. You can simply come focus on your training part. So tomorrow, this is a meeting ID for tomorrow program. I'll share in the personal chat, in this chat box. And this is a next training program, which we are launching. I am from, we are having a training institute called Tamila Academy. So this training on power your presentation, it is about how to prepare your own presentation. It will be having 2 hours of training program. The investment of those program is just 150 rupees, and it will be by 27th of April. So this is my social media pages, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube, all those are comes under in Tamila Kartik. This is my contact number. You can reach me at any time. If you have any doubts, you can post in chat. I am really happy that many people are watching on live in Facebook. Thank you so much for your patient listening. If you have any doubts, you can reach my number, which is displayed in the screen, in the previous screen. You can reach my number at any time. Thank you so much. If you have doubts, you can ask me now.